You saw an NBC report which detailed President Trump describing a career intelligence analyst as a pretty Korean lady, asking her where she was from. And then you tweeted this. You said, President Trump made a lot of upsetting remarks this week, including this one. Where are you from? Is a question that many Asian Americans dread. Explain that to people.
I think, Don, that if somebody says, what's your name and where you're from, then that is innocuous and totally harmless. But when somebody says, no, but where are you really from, I think that that is a microaggression, that is just veiled interest, that if you call them out on it, the interest is, well, I'm just curious where you're actually from. But what they're veiling is this predetermined answer that they have, this view of a default American looks a certain way, and it doesn't compute if you say that you, as this career analyst said, well, I'm from New York, I'm from Manhattan, just like you. And so it doesn't compute for some people, so then they want to say, okay, well, where are you really from? And so that is a form, like I said, of this feigned interest in you.
Well, you're talking about basically you were describing the situation. You said President Trump interrupted an intel briefing to ask a career intelligence officer, where are you from? When she said New York, he basically asked, no, where are you really from? And when she said she was from Manhattan, just like the president, he was still unsatisfied and he wanted to know where your people are from. And after the analyst revealed that her parents are Korean, Trump turned to an advisor in the room and seemed to suggest her ethnicity should determine her career path, asking why the pretty Korean lady isn't negotiating with North Korea on his administration's behalf. That's what the official said, and that's a report that you saw.
That's exactly right. And luckily, you got a pretty Korean man in front of you, but nobody's ever said that. Yeah. And I think that the reality of all of this, the reason I tweeted this, Don, is because in contrast, in the Obama family, in the Obama White House, we really celebrated diversity. And like I said, it's not just that my parents were from Korea. The person who sat right outside the Oval, her parents were from Iran. And there were parents from India and Ethiopia and Bolivia and Mexico. And as well as these people that have rich histories in Kansas and Illinois and Minnesota and Maryland and Massachusetts. And we all came together because President Obama inspired this generation of people for this common good, and then we could celebrate our diversities, and that made us so much stronger. Mm-hmm. I want to make clear that I am really humbled to be a representative for those people, because that's my family.
That's what America is about, and I see you're broken up about that, and I'm sure our audience is the same way, but that's really what the American dream is all about, right? That's what immigration is all about.
Yeah, I think that we are all living proof. Not just my tweets, but we are all living proof that the American dream is possible, that you could... I'm emotional because I haven't slept in 2 days, and I've been trying to read everybody's tweets, which have been so beautiful and emotional to me. I wanted to work at the White House, or I wanted to be in public service. All of my friends wanted to be in public service. And I'm so thankful to all of them and to President Obama and